Hey, church family. My name is Heather. I wanted to come alongside you guys and encourage you with a verse that has been super encouraging to me over these last couple weeks. Perhaps it's a verse that we've heard before, perhaps we haven't, but it's always just a great reminder. And that is found in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. When we get there, we see that Paul is writing a letter to Timothy. He knows that Timothy is more on the timid side, but he sees Timothy's sincere faith, and he just wants to come alongside him and encourage him and remind him that God has given him everything that he needs. So 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7 says, "For God has not given us a spirit of timidity, but of power and love and discipline." So when you read that verse, what does that look like? You know, after all, God has created us with feelings, and it can be very much a part of our reality. Fear can be such a strong driving force when it comes to our decision making. Sometimes it's for good, and oftentimes it can be negative. We will be fearful at times. We are human, but don't let that fear overcome you. And that's what Paul is reminding Timothy about, and that's what God constantly reminds us throughout all of the Bible. Fear not. He says it so many times, fear not. So when we break this verse down and we look at it, what does it look like to not have the spirit of timidity? For me, I needed to look at the opposite of what being timid means, and that is to have courage, to be bold, and to have confidence. That courage that this will pass and you will still be held in the palm of his hands. That boldness to proclaim his name on high. And that confidence that he's going to finish what he started and that he will be with us every single step of the way. But what I love about this verse is that the Lord doesn't stop here. He says that we will have the spirit of power and love and discipline. That power to not grow weary and to have that strength to carry on through our day to day, through our ministry, whether it be our ministry at church, our ministry in our neighborhood, in our community, whatever it might be, having that strength to continue on. But definitely not by our strength, but from his. That love, he's given us that power of love that when we see others, we see their souls in light of eternity and all the ways that we can be the hands and feet of Jesus. And that discipline, that sound mind that we have because we are able to see through the lenses of Scripture. you know, this is the first time that we, as a nation, as a whole, has been brought to its knees. And when you see that, it can be terrifying at times. But man, when that fear doesn't overcome you, when you remove that fear, you see people on their knees. You see people searching. You see people crying out to God. People figuring out how to even pray. You see relationships with him strengthened and deepened. You see hope and you see opportunity to let your light shine for our Heavenly Father. So I just want to encourage you guys that when you are feeling this fear that tends to overcome you, just stop and pray and cast all your fears on him, because man, he wants them and he loves you and he is so willing and able, right? So stop, pray, cast all your cares upon him. If you have to do it on the daily, that is awesome, because that shows that you're not dependent on your own strength. You are solely dependent on him. And if you have to do that every single day, especially during this time, that's okay. In our weakness, he is strong. So remind yourself of that. Fill yourself up with the Spirit. Fill your mind on things above. Saturate yourself in his word. I know you guys hear that time and time again. I know I do too, and that's because it's so important. Saturate yourself in his word and trust. After you've prayed, after you have filled yourself up with the things above, just trust. Trust his character. Trust what you know, what you know, what you know. That the Lord is always going to be there. He's always going to provide for you with the things that is best for you when he desires. So I hope this really, truly finds you guys. Seeing this is just an opportunity to come with boldness, with courage, and a light for Jesus in this very, very dark world, because right now they need it. We need it. So I hope that encourages you. Love you guys, and I will talk to you soon.